Hello everyone, I am from India. My name is Aradhya, and if you didn't get it right, it's fine. Nobody here got it right. Opportunity. Is it too hard to get? Is it too hard to find? Is it only for the lucky? Is it only for the hard workers? The answer filled me up with contentment. The answer to all the questions is no. Opportunity, in fact, is one of the most prevalent, residing in every nook and corner and everywhere in between. It was provided to us in form of votes to decide the future of our country. It was provided to us when we could have put ourselves, our health, our well-being first. It was provided to us when we could have prioritized wellness as a part of our daily lifestyle. It was provided to us to implement ingenious and innovative ideas, to mobilize others, to inspire others, to recognize our power as a change maker. Opportunity and choices go hand in hand. So yes, opportunities are not hard to find. But what takes a toll is to identify when they knock on the door. And what's even harder is to grabbing onto them. Believing that you possess innate skills and motives is what will enable you to achieve what you aspire for. Leave no stones unturned to prove your dexterity, the perseverance, the dedication you have put forward to bring the changes you want to see dawning upon this planet. In a nutshell, the transformation that I witnessed in 30 days was the skill that I acquired along the journey, the skill to identify the opportunity that existed 30 days back and still does, the skill to act upon the opportunity I am provided with. PGC played a major role in self-actualization. And today, me giving this presentation is just a small part of humongous transformation that I had along the journey. It made me realize that I was no more blind even after having a healthy pair of eyes. It turned me into a more vigilant individual, transforming me and many others from conventional to conscious. The precarious condition in which the environment is in right now is in front of everybody. But we choose to turn a blind eye towards it, a deaf ear towards it. Why? Why do we choose to be so abominable? Why do we choose to be so inconsiderate? Why do we opt for such an insensitive choice? Maybe because we are scared that we aren't capable enough to make a difference. Scared that our small idea won't be prominent for a world of billions. Scared that all our efforts will go in vain. But we need to understand that the first step of achieving is believing. Believing in our power. Believing in our ideas. Believing in our values. Believing in hope. Troubled times call for ingenious ideas. And I hope that within each of us breeds an exceptional idea which can do wonders if nurtured aptly. We all indeed are just small drops, but what is an ocean? Just a multitude of drops. These are some challenges that we won along the journey. Each day was an opportunity to learn something new. Each day was an opportunity to bring change in our campus. Each day, we could learn stories from all over the world and get inspired. And this is my team. Akshata Joshi, Bhupinder Singh, Anadi Manloi, and me. We are all in same class, but there's one more thing that connects us. 25,000 people die of hunger every day. 25,000. There are millions of people sleeping with empty stomach every night. So what do? So we realized that the problem is not lack of food. The problem is lack of access to the available food. So what we did, that we joined an organization which has contacts from every restaurant present in our city, every wedding planner. So whenever there is surplus food left in restaurant or in weddings, they call us and we go to them, collect the food and make sure that it's fresh, it's consumable, and then distribute amongst the slums. I would like to share a small story about this. So one day we were all sitting together and we get a call from a wedding. Indian weddings are very huge. There are many people. So the wedding planner called us and said that there's food for 5,000 people. And if you guys want to do something about it, do it. So 5,000 people, ladies and gentlemen, 5,000 meals that would have gone through trash. 5,000. So we went up to them, collected the food, distributed amongst the slums, different slums of the city, distributed to the roadsiders, outsiders, everyone in need, till 5 in the morning. And we called this organization Robin Hood Army, because we all are Robins. During our journey, we took survey and asked what others felt about the activities we do. 60% were astonished, 70% were curious, 50% were ignorant, and 90% questioned. We believe that any change that needs to be brought in this world needs 4 integral things. Will. Will to do something amazing. Will to bring a change in this world. Belief. Belief that we can actually make an impact. Belief that our power is more than we think it is. Approach. Approach to invest our energy in right direction. Approach to channelize our efforts. And action. Once we get done with the plan, getting our ideas into action. PGC is just the beginning. We won't stop. We won't stop learning. We won't stop inspiring. We won't stop until our ultimate goal is achieved. Ultimate goal of saving this planet. And for that, we have ideology of 6 E's. Establish, enlighten, enhance, expand, execute, and empower. Honestly, these 30 days and this weekend was the best time of my life. It was my dream to come to America, and it is amazing to be here. It is really amazing to be here. I would like to thank Turning Green for making this possible. This is exceptional. This is the time of my life representing this country, representing my country. Actually, I have a flag with me, so I'll just have it because. And I would just like to share a small story when I was coming to America just a night before. So my mom calls me in her room and says, in Hindi, beta, mujhe tum pe bahut garv hai, which translates to, son, I am proud of you. And that was the best feeling in my life. In the end, I would just end up by saying a quote by Robert Swan. He says, the greatest threat to our environment is to believe that someone else will save it. Thank you.